Get your backpack ready. It's time to plan a trip. This week, in our whirlwind tour of the history of science, let's travel to Stonehenge. We will also survey the history of ideas about the shape of the Earth. These topics are specially chosen to help us think about historiography. Historiography is a fancy word that means how to interpret the past. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we begin to explore the strange new world of pre-modern history of science. Though we have just a limited time to visit, we'll not be like tourists who seek fast food at McDonald's. Our aim will be to get to know the makers of Stonehenge and those who investigated the shape of the Earth before Columbus in terms of their own place and time, not just in terms of modern science. Have you visited Stonehenge or any other similar stone circle? Have you watched any movies or documentaries about Stonehenge? You may be surprised at some of the ways people have interpreted Stonehenge. What did the makers of Stonehenge make it for? How did they use it? What answers to these questions have been given in the past? How can we answer such questions today? What can we learn from the case of Stonehenge about how to interpret the past? Likewise, you may be surprised at the story of the shape of the Earth. Who discovered that the Earth is round? What evidence did they have? When did this discovery become widely known? What can we learn from this story about how to interpret the past? The stories of Stonehenge and the shape of the Earth both lead us to the stars. Thomas Carlyle asked, "Why did not somebody teach me the constellations and make me at home in the starry heavens, which are always overhead and which I don't know to this day?" The nighttime sky is part of the common heritage of humanity, embodied in the stories, art, music, and culture of every pre-modern people. When was the last time you went outside and watched the stars? When was the last time you visited a planetarium or learn to recognize a new constellation? Can you find the Big Dipper, the Little Dipper? Can you use the Big Dipper to find other constellations? Can you identify the winter hexagon or the summer triangle? Orion the Hunter, Leo the Lion, Cygnus the Swan? What are your favorite constellations and constellation stories? Have you noticed the days growing shorter in the fall and longer in the spring? Have you noticed how the sun rises at different locations on the eastern horizon, depending on the time of year? Have you ever tried to track the motion of the sun around the constellations over the course of a year? Or track the moon around the sky in the course of a month? Would it surprise you to discover that early civilizations and even pre-literate communities were familiar with the nighttime sky and followed the motions of the planets against the background of the constellations? Whenever we're planning a trip to places and times in the past, we want to better understand what people thought they were up to. What are some similarities between our culture today and people in the past? How might these similarities help us to understand the science of the past? What are some differences between our culture today and people in the past? How might these differences pose an obstacle to our understanding of what they were up to? Are we even aware of the night sky that they took for granted? What do you think might be the chief barrier that obstructs our modern appreciation of science in the past? Look at this colorized woodcut, which I've chosen as the icon for the course. What stands out to you in this woodcut? What do you see? What details interest you? What does this illustration have to do with the history of science? Have you seen it before? Do you know where it comes from? Do you think it makes an appropriate icon or theme or symbol for this course? What does it mean to you? To me, this woodcut means that we have set out on a journey of discovery and exploration. To me, that red figure is you, seeking the unknown. Please share your thoughts on these things. As we begin our journey into past times and places to explore the story of science in pre-modern cultures, what are your starting assumptions?